So while we have to wait, why don't we get ourselves outrageously healthy on these?
Oh, no, thank you.
Well, I think that we ought to get to know each other a little better.
I think we know each other quite well, Alexis.
I wonder. Do you really know that I happen to have a great deal of respect for you?
No, that hadn't crossed my mind recently.
There, you see, we do have things to learn about each other. I think you are a very bright young woman, Kirby.
Thank you.
Come and sit down. Your father was a very perceptive man. He realized the value of a good education. 4 years at the Sorbonne does not come cheaply.
Oh, I know.
And you proved the value of that education when you worked as an interpreter for Adam at Colbico. And your value to my company did not go unnoticed by me.
Are we going to talk about us, Alexis, or about Colbico?
Well, both, actually. You see, a position has just become available in Paris for which I think you are eminently suitable.
I have no intention.
Now, hear me out. With that position goes the use of my apartment on the Avenue Foch, a car and a chauffeur, and a very substantial salary. And just think, more importantly, you'll be in Paris, where you want to be.
I'd be where you want me to be.
Kirby, I am offering you a bribe.
Stay away from my son, Kirby, and I'll make it worth your while.
And I will.
No sale, Alexis. I was raped right here in this room by your son. Did you know that? And now you're trying to do the same thing. I have news for you, lady. I may have lost a child, a Carrington baby, but I promise you, my next one will also be a Carrington.
We're out of your reach, Kirby. You don't belong.
I've made up my mind to belong wherever I say I belong.
Before you make your transition, I think there's something you should know about your past.
What are you talking about?
You think that simply by marrying Adam and having a child that you can create a Carrington? Well, check your own bloodline, Kirby, because if I were you with your background, I'd adopt a child.
My father was just as good as anyone in this family.
Who's talking about your father? I'm talking about your mother.
My mother died when I was a baby.
You may wish that she had, but I can assure you that she is alive. She is very much alive.
I don't want to hear any more of this.
Your father had to live with the truth, so why shouldn't you? She ran away, Kirby, when you were 2 years old. She ran off with her lover. And when he didn't satisfy her anymore, she killed him.
No.
Your father should have had the courage to tell you himself, instead of blaming me for that letter from the grave. Your mother's in prison.
No, I don't believe you.
And not just an ordinary jail. It's a prison for the criminally insane.
You're a liar! A liar!
Read this. Am I a liar? Or am I just a mother who's protecting her son? Read it, Kirby.